Hello guys, welcome to my channel. So in today's session we will see how do we send the automation execution results over the email. So as we have seen in earlier sessions, how do we use email utilities to read the OTP and how to generate date utilities, etc. So now today's session we will focus on how we generate or how do we send our execution reports as an attachment and send it over the email. So as you know, in general, if you are running any TestNG test script, it will generate test output folder. So this is we have seen in assertions class, right? So whenever you run any test script using TestNG plugin, that will generate one test output folder, and this folder contains various results. So one of such report is emailable report. Now we will see how do we send this report over the email. So that is the requirement. So let's create a small test to see how it works. Just this is my using automation utilities. This is the project we created. And you know, before you start writing a script, make sure you have downloaded automation utilities.fro and add it to your project. Okay, so this is the utility which have so many reusable methods to send emails. And to know more about it, you can follow the first session of this Selenium utilities web YouTube series. So you can watch the first video where I'm showing how to configure and where we download this jar file and how do we add this jar file to your project. So once it is added, now it has certain email utilities. Those utilities we will be using in today's class. This is my email utilities. Okay, so let's create a small test before we run. Create a TestNG class. Okay, so before test, after test, there's a test already exist. This is the one which we have already there, the new test. Okay, so either you can use the same one or you can create the new one. So I'm trying to use the same one. So but here, make sure we need to send the execution reports over the email. That is the topic, today's topic. And forget about this, I'm closing this. And this test has three test methods. This is the scenario 2, scenario 1, and scenario 3. And here I'm launching the web driver. And here I'm closing the web driver. So if I run this, let's see. Now this will execute the script. There are three test methods, so it executes all three test methods and it generates one output, test output. See, it was generated at 3:06 p.m. just now, and you see emailable output generated. You see this is the emailable report. So now the requirement is to send this over the email. Okay, so for this I am depending upon email utilities. So, and I guess this should be after test method because this is the where we are closing everything. Means our test execution endpoint is this. After this, I wanted to send the results to your team. Okay. So then type email utilities and use this utility, email utils. Email utils equals to new email utils. Okay. So create object, and it has various methods. I'm using one of such method is send using Gmail. Okay, so you can use SMTP if you have SMTP details. So as I don't have SMTP server with me, I cannot show you. But if your organization is having SMTP, then you can use this. But you need to define the properties. In the property file, you need to define your SMTP details. But now I'm showing about this one, send using Gmail. and properties you need to define. Regarding the properties, this is the property file you need to create, config. Okay, I have three property files, but one should be good. Okay, it should have your Gmail username, Gmail password, Gmail port, and from where you wanted to send email, and to whom we need to send emails. Okay, so this step you need to follow. Okay, so this is the basic requirement, and make sure this should given the same name, Gmail underscore username underscore password underscore port, and everything should be same, and only you need to replace this with your Gmail ID with your Gmail password, and port should be same, and to and this is your Gmail ID and where you wanted to send your result file. So for example, you can send it to the same, or it's up to you. If you wanted to send it to many, you can give the comma separated. Okay, so this is the configuration file which you need to make sure. Okay, and now to read the values from configuration file, you need to define a properties class. This is Java properties class where it can give you to load the values from the property file. Property dot load is a method. Okay, and this will take file input stream as a object. So I'm creating the file input stream, and here you need to pass your property file path. So I'm using this lab2 properties. Okay, so just give the path up to this, up to dot properties you are giving. Okay, and subject line. So now this send using Gmail will use this method, right? So this this properties which we are loading over here, so that all your Gmail related details are stored in the property object. Now subject means execution results, and here you need to mention your message, IT execution is successful. So you can write your own message, and here you need to send the attachment. So this attachment is a list you need to define. So here I am passing the, I'm declaring one list, it's a string. Okay, so I'm declaring one variable, attachments equals to new array list. Okay, so now for attachment I'm adding the file attachment dot add. So which file we need to add? We need to add a test output file. This is the one, right? And this is the file we need to add an attachment. Copy this path. Okay, test output, and you need to attach this file, email report.html. okay, so this is how you can add. What is this? Just mouse over. Okay, declare some exceptions here also. Trust declaration, and if you wanted to add multiple attachments, you can add it to your list, like attachments dot add, which file you wanted to add from here, index.html or whatever you wanted, you can give, so that it the mail will be triggered with your attachments. Okay, so this is how you can add your Gmail. Okay, so now once you run it, let's see, right click, run as test ng test, let's see what will happen. This is loading. Now your test is running and done. Okay, so the terminated, and I think first message sent successfully. You got this message means the email is generated. So now let me check my email ID here. gmail.com test automation lab 2. Those are the, this file is holding my test automation lab 2.details. This is nothing but my config file. This is similar, this is the file I'm using. This is similar to this, but I'm having test automation lab 2 at gmail.com with my own password. That's why I'm not able to show this file, but this is similar to whatever. This is what I shown over here. Okay, now see the mail is generated. Test automation lab 2, test execution results. Hi team, execution is successful. And this is your result file. And you can download it and see this. This is how it will. So even you can generate one more. Hi team, execution is successful. I'm changing clean find attack. Okay. And you can say that test execution status 12 means December 2020. This is today's date. Okay. Save it. Right click. Run as. Now your test is running. Running. Okay, so there is some issue. Maybe password are not accepted. Don't know, maybe did I change anything? It should accept. Config lab 2. I'm not sure why this is. Let me sign out and retry this. Config lab 2. Yep, no change. Okay, let me retry. Yeah, this is message sent successfully. So maybe I was opened in a browser. That might be the reason. So let me recheck my test automation lab 2 email. So this is in the test sent emails, you see, this is sending to this .clip labs email, and you see emailable report. Hi team, execution is successful. Please find attached, and test execution status is December 15, 2020. So this is how it will generate your execution reports, and you can use your Gmail ID. For this purpose, you can create one test email. We can use it for your automation team to send the results across. So this is how you can use email utilities to generate the email and send the execution reports over the Gmail as an attachment. So I hope this will be useful for you. Thanks for watching this video.